Hello everyone. Today we will learn Unit 3 C#.NET. In this unit, we will start topic error handling and string manipulation. I am your instructor Kruti Patel from LG Institute of Engineering Technology. First topic, error handling or structured exception handling. Exception handling in C# is a process to handle runtime errors. We perform exception handling so that normal flow of application can be maintained even after runtime errors. In C#, exception is an event or object which is thrown at runtime. All exceptions are derived from system.exception class. It is a runtime error which can be handled. If we do not handle the exception, it prints exception message and terminates the program. Its advantages are, it maintains the normal flow of the application. In such case, the rest of the code is executed even after exception. C# exception handling keywords are four: first, try; second, catch; third, finally; and fourth, throw. Syntax is as below. Try will have some code. The code which may raise the errors, it will return in a try. Then after catch, which will handle the exception, and finally block will do some final cleanup code. First, try block. As per the above syntax, put the code in the try block that may raise an exception followed by catch or finally block. The try block in C# is used to place the code that may throw exception. Keep variable declarations out of the try block so that they can be accessed in a catch and finally blocks. Second is catch block. Exception raised within try block can be handled using the catch block. Code in the catch block will only execute when the exception occurs. A multiple catch block can also be specified with the different exception type is called exception filters. A multiple catch block is useful when you want to handle different exceptions in different ways. Next is finally block. The finally block must come after a try or catch block. The finally block will always be executed whether or not an exception is thrown. The final block is generally used for cleaning up code, for example, for disposing an unmanaged objects, etc. The catch block is used to handle the exception. The catch block must be preceded by try block. C# finally block is used to execute important code which is to be executed whether the exception is handled or not. It must be preceded by catch or try block. Now we will see the practical demonstration of error handling. For this, I'll open Visual Studio. And here I have code for error handling. Here you can see in main function, I have written these three blocks, that is try, catch, and finally. Here in try block, I have taken these number n1 and n2 variables, and respectively 5 and 0 values are stored in that variables. First, I have written this statement for showing you the execution steps. So first I have written step 1, then after I'll perform a division of n1 and n2, but here n2 contain value 0, so with 0 division is not possible, so divide by 0 exception which mentioning catch block will be thrown. So here when it compiler perform this step, this catch block will execute because division with 0 is not possible. So after this line, catch block will execute, so it print exception whatever will be thrown. Then after, it does not return in step 2 because after executing the catch block, it will go in finally. So in finally block, I have written step 3. It will show you that step 3 will always execute, so whether our exception is thrown or not. So such compulsory, like dereference the objects type statements are always written in step, are written in finally block. So now I'll run this code. Here you can see step 1 is executed, but it does not print step 2 because here exception will thrown and it directly goes in divide by zero exception. You can see here, after throwing this exception in step after step 1, it will goes in catch block, and after catching the exception, the final block will executes. So it does not print this step 2 due to exception occur. You can see its output. Step 1 is here, here exception is printed, and here step 3, which contained in final block, will execute. So you can see your code. Try block will contain the division operation with 0. Cache will contain the exception, which is tagged by the cache block, and finally will contain some statement. So if I'll do here 1, first I need to stop debug. Then I'll change its value. When I run this code, I'll get its division value. So here you can see all steps are performed. So here step 1 is executed, then no exception occur here, so cache block will not executed. It prints its value, and then after step 2 and step 3 is executed. So here you can see it is a code for exception handling. Next topic is string manipulation. Now we will see, in C# programming, string is another kind of data type that represent Unicode characters. It is the alias of system.string, or you can also write system, the string instead of string. It is sequence of character in which each character is Unicode character. There is no difference between string and string because string is alias of system.string. So capital S indicate it's a class and small s indicate a data type. But when you are getting some class members, so it will not difference between the small and capital string. Most of the developers get confused what to use between string and string. Technically, there is no difference between them, but they can use of any of them. Now we will see the practical demonstration of string manipulation. But before it, we will see some C# string functions. Now here, you can see these are the methods of string. You can create a clone, concat, contains, copy, and with, equals, insert. These are method of string. Here, description of string functions is available. Next, there are another methods. We can remove some part from string, replace string. We can find substring. We can also convert lowercase, uppercase, or train the strings. So you can see these are different methods. And here description is provided of that method. We will use these methods and we'll see practical demonstration of the string. So first we will see a program which is of string manipulation functions. So for it, I'll open Visual Studio, file, new project, and I'll find first code of string function. Here you can see first line is console.writeline, enter a string A. So we'll enter any string here. It will be stored in A. Same way we'll enter another string that will be stored in B. Here by default input string format is string, so no need to convert into a string. Then after, we will concat this both of string A and B with space, and it will be stored in variable C string. So now C is printed. Then after, by using the built-in function, here I've used two upper and two lower for converting that string into respectively uppercase and lowercase. So here the string is converted into uppercase by two upper method, and it is converted into lowercase through two lower method. So the string C, which is nothing but a concatenation of these A and B, it will be respectively converted into uppercase and lowercase through two upper and two lower method. And finally, we will add any another string which is stored in D. So that added new string will replace original A string. So now our added D string, which is D, is replaced. It will replace a string A. So you will get a replaced string A, which is replaced by D string. So I'll run this code. You can see here I'm entering hello in string A, but I'll add O capital. String B is world. I'll add W capital. Now concatenated string is, our concatenated string is hello world. Uppercase is hello world in capital letters, and here is a small letter, lowercase string. And now I'll enter any another string, which is hi. So hi is replaced. Hi will replace a string hello. So here hello is replaced by hi. So I can give the concatenated string hi one. So you can see these are the functions which is used in string. Our next program is practical demonstration of reverse string using reverse function. So I'll open the code for reverse string. You can see here it is a code to reverse any string. So for that, I need to enter any string. So whatever the user will enter the string, it will be stored in str. Now here, note this point. Our entered string will convert it into character array through two character array method, and it will be stored in character x, means char x. That is nothing but the name of array, which is a type of character. So if I have entered hello, then H, E, double L, O, respectively, these characters are stored in character type array. Now I'll use this array.reverse method of that character. So it will convert the array into reverse order. And now I have printed each and every character by forish loop. You can see here. So our reverse order string will be displayed. So I'll run this code. I have entered hello, and you can see here your reverse string is O double L E H. So it is a code to reverse any string. Last code is the practical demonstration of sorting a string in alphabetical order. So for it, I'll open code, file, new project, alphabetical order. Here you can see we have entered some string in variable str, which is type of string data type. Our entered string is converted into character array, which is name charx of type character data type, through the method two character array, and it is nothing but the method of string. You can see here string str, and I have written str dot two character array. So it will use the method of string, which is two character array, for converting the string into character array. So whatever the array character is converted, it will be now sorted through the method sort of array class. So array.sort is written here, and it will sort this one character array charx. Now the sorted, alphabetical sorted array will print it through this code. So for each character C in char, and it will print each and every character which are sorted in alphabetical order. So I'll run this code. I have written here B C A Z J H. Now you can see your alphabetical order output is A B C H J Z. So here these are the programs of string, which manipulate a string, reverse string, and alphabetical order. Thank you, everyone.